Major Depressive Disorder, or MDD, the diagnostic criteria state that a person needs to have demonstrated five or more symptoms during the same two-week period for most of the day, nearly every day. That the person's presentation needs to represent a significant change compared to their previous functioning, and that one of the five symptoms needs to be either persistent sad mood most of the day and on most days, or loss of interest or pleasure. It is worth noting that in children and adolescents, persistent sad mood may also manifest as irritable mood. When we talk about a loss of interest or pleasure in previously enjoyed activities, we are referring to what we call anhedonia. Let me give you an example of what I mean. Imagine that you have a friend who, before they became depressed, was a really active person with lots of interests. Maybe they were really into watching Game of Thrones, listening to music, playing touch football, hanging out with friends, and gaming. These are some of the things that they enjoyed doing in their spare time. Then they became depressed, and now they have absolutely no interest in doing any of these things. Their friends repeatedly say things like, "Mate, you need to come over. We're going to have an epic night. We're going to have a Grand Theft Auto tournament, and then we're going to watch season two of Game of Thrones. And if we feel up to it in the morning, we'll go and have a game of touch football in the park." Your friend, who is experiencing depression, is going to say no. And they'll be thinking something along the lines of, "No, that has no interest for me, no appeal." If they were to accept the invitation, they wouldn't enjoy it. So this symptom is about a loss of interest or pleasure in activities that used to be enjoyable or pleasurable. Another symptom is a significant change in weight or appetite in either direction, so either an increase or a decrease. In relation to weight, if there is a weight loss, it is occurring in the absence of a deliberate attempt to lose weight. In other words, the person is not dieting. Whether we're talking about a weight loss or gain, we're looking at a change of more than 5% of the person's body weight in the space of 1 month. If we're thinking about this symptom in relation to a growing child or adolescent, a failure to gain expected weight could count here. Another symptom is the change in sleep patterns, again, in either direction, either insomnia or hypersomnia. But probably the more likely thing is that a person is going to sleep more when they're depressed. Partly, this is because people do become very tired when they're depressed. If you have ever been very, very sad yourself, whether that's through perhaps grief or your own experience of depression, it is actually physically exhausting to be sad for a prolonged period of time. But the desire to sleep can also be an escape mechanism of sorts, a desire to escape the symptoms of depression. And so you hear people saying things like, "I just wish I could be asleep the whole time so that I don't have to think the thoughts I'm thinking, so I don't have to feel the way I feel." Just a couple of weeks ago, a 17-year-old girl told me that she felt like the song "Wake Me Up When It's All Over" was the soundtrack of her life. For some people, this way of thinking gets taken to its logical extreme conclusion and becomes suicidal thinking or ideation. "I wish I didn't have to be here. If only I could just be dead so I don't have to feel the way I feel." Another symptom relates to psychomotor behaviour, either agitation or what's referred to as retardation. When we are talking about psychomotor agitation, we are talking about someone who, for example, is very fidgety and can't sit still when they're depressed. With psychomotor retardation, we're looking at people's movement being really reduced and slowed. Psychomotor retardation is a very common part of a depressive presentation. It's very common to hear people who are experiencing depression say things like, "I just can't get myself out of bed. It feels too hard to get out of bed." And people who are experiencing depression can literally spend days in bed, getting up only to go to the bathroom and fetch food. Fatigue or loss of energy is another symptom. Now, you may be thinking to yourself, "Oh, surely everybody feels tired and like they have no energy from time to time." And this is very true. The DSM tells us, though, that the symptoms must represent a significant change from the person's previous level of functioning. In addition, one of the other DSM criteria tells us that the symptoms of major depressive disorder must cause either clinically significant distress or impairment in a person's functioning. This idea of distress and or impairment in functioning is absolutely critical when it comes to thinking about most of the mental illnesses. This is because many of the symptoms of different mental illnesses, particularly the depressive and anxiety disorders, are things that everyone can experience from time to time. Other symptoms include recurrent thoughts of worthlessness or excessive or inappropriate guilt nearly every day, which may even be delusional, and a diminished ability to think or concentrate or indecisiveness nearly every day, either as reported by the person themselves or as observed by others. So a person experiencing this particular symptom may appear easily distracted or demonstrate difficulties with concentration. The final symptom is recurrent thoughts of death, but not just a fear of dying. This refers instead to recurrent suicidal thoughts or ideation without a specific plan, or a suicide attempt or a specific plan for committing suicide. Diagnosis requires that the five or more symptoms demonstrated from these criteria cause clinically significant distress and or impairment in functioning, for example, social or occupational functioning.